It is my great joy that, you know, to introduce you to Ambassador Richard Morningstar, who will be joining us from Washington, D.C. Today. And he is the founding chairman of the Global Energy Center at the Atlantic Council. He served as the U.S. ambassador to Azerbaijan from July 2012 to August 2014. And prior to his appointment, since April 2009, he was the Secretary of State Special Envoy for Eurasian Energy. At that time, when I had the opportunity also to work together with him as we were building the Southern Corridor, now we call it TANAP, in Turkey. So, my former colleagues, my mentor, you know, Dick Morningstar, you know, just the floor is yours, and looking forward to hearing you. We have a great crowd here, Dick, and wonderful to see you again.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much, Daphne, for your very kind introduction, and it's always great to see you, even if only virtually. And I'm certainly very happy this morning in the United States, anyway, to be able to join you for this terrific 2022 Regional Clean Energy Outlook Conference, Advanced Climate and Security Goals, that you're holding in Istanbul, and appreciate the live audience in Istanbul and around the world. And I know that day one has already featured some outstanding panels on geopolitics and on new nuclear technologies. I know you're going to have more today and have a great schedule for tomorrow. I'm also really happy to be with you today because, you know, Turkey's just a really important country, and it's an important crossroads for energy, and that importance is only going to increase in the future throughout the green transition, and also given the present geopolitics of energy. And we certainly think that the discussions that you're having here this week can chart a course for Turkey to be an energy hub for years to come, enabling a sustainable and secure energy system within the broader region, stretching all the way through Europe. And especially after Russia's outrageous actions against Ukraine. And, you know, even while you've been in the conference today, Russia has attacked several cities within Ukraine. It's clear that Europe and the world can never, never, ever revert to the pre-war status quo of reliance on Russian energy. And decarbonization will be the key for ending that reliance. But diversifying energy imports in the near term, not just from the energy transition, but also fossil fuels, will be an important part of the equation. And Turkey has always been and continues to be a crucial partner for the United States and Europe in efforts to meet current demand for fossil fuels through alternative supply routes. The country is going to be important also for collaborative efforts to decrease the carbon intensity of fossil energy and to carry through the transition to a lower carbon system. You know, we always have to remember that Turkey is a key regional ally for the United States. The overall U.S.-Turkey relationship has been a positive one. There have been ups and downs over the years, but energy and cooperation in energy has always been, I believe anyway, the one consistent part of the relationship. And the United States and the Transatlantic Alliance are stronger for having Turkey as a partner. Turkey is the gateway to Europe, to diversify through partnerships both in, you know, in the Eastern Mediterranean and in the Caspian regions. Turkey's cooperation in transiting oil and gas from these regions has made it a linchpin for regional energy cooperation and regional energy security. I'm proud over the course of my career in the U.S. federal government to have worked with partners in Ankara and in other regional capitals to build the Baku-Tbilisi-Ceyhan pipeline, which, as you know, delivers crude oil from the Caspian to international markets through Turkey. You know, this project was once derided as a pipe dream. I can remember one day waking up back, this is back in the late 90s, and there was a headline, literally a headline, on the front page of the New York Times saying that this Baku Tbilisi Ceyhan was a pipe dream. That was the words in the headline, that it was infeasible and overly ambitious. But through the cooperation with Turkey and our partners in the South Caucasus, this happened. And today, Baku Tbilisi Ceyhan has the capacity to deliver 1.2 million barrels per day of oil to Ceyhan and the rest of the world. And that limits Russia's ability to keep Caspian crude oil out of global markets right now. And in fact, the recent attempts by Moscow to control oil going from Kazakhstan through Russia and out the Black Sea just shows again the importance and wiseness of the decision to go ahead with Baku Tbilisi Ceyhan and the incredible role that Turkey played in that. And as Daphne mentioned, I'm also was very much participated in the Southern Gas Corridor. And again, the whole idea of the Southern Gas Corridor was to get one more gas to Turkey and more gas to Europe to serve as an alternative to Russian gas. There were a lot of naysayers at the time, but it's done. It was done. And successful in good part because of the TANAP pipeline going through Turkey. And now, as a result of Russia's action, there's a new memorandum of understanding between the EU and Azerbaijan with the cooperation of Turkey to double export volumes to Europe from the Caspian by 2027. The Southern Gas Corridor is a vital conduit of gas. And what's also important is that memorandum of understanding also pledges to assist Azerbaijan, and this is something in which Turkey could be heavily involved in developing hydrogen and renewables and to reduce the methane intensiveness of gas production, which is going to be critically important. And these measures can mitigate climate impact while increasing the economy of not just Azerbaijan, but the countries in the region, including Turkey, and enabling Turkey to contribute to regional energy security for decades to come. So Turkey plays a key role in this transformation and is a gateway for hydrogen transport. And indeed, Turkey's role in the energy transition will be multifaceted. Turkey has a positive story to tell in enabling the green transition. The country's already a leading player in geothermal power deployment and solar panel manufacturing. Turkey gets about a third of its electricity from hydropower and is getting more and more from wind. And Turkey's building four nuclear projects that will strengthen the low carbon backbone of its energy system. And I know at the Atlantic Council, virtually all of us believe that nuclear power and safe nuclear power and new nuclear technologies that I know that you talked about in the prior panel are absolutely key to the energy transition. So Turkey can play a leading role in the region by accelerating its clean power development to help build secure energy systems as we move into the future. So even against long odds through cross-border and public-private sector collaboration, this region has a proven track record of making the impossible possible. And we hope that the conversations here in Istanbul will further contribute to the region's compelling energy story. And again, I can't emphasize enough how important Turkey is to the energy future of the region and to Europe, and really to the rest of the world. And so thank you for joining us today and contributing to these shared objectives. And Defne, I pass the microphone, I guess, back to you, and thank you for having me speak here today. Thank you.
So why don't we give a big applause to Ambassador Richard Morningstar from Istanbul.
Thank you.
Ambassador Morningstar, we all wish you were here with us, hopefully next year. And just sending our regards and greetings from here. We already had a great discussion this morning, and we will have more today and tomorrow. And thank you for your contribution and remarks, which also marked the day. And so hopefully see you back in Washington, D.C.
Thank you. Thank you, Defne. Great
thank
to
you.
Be with
thank you. Thank you. Okay, greetings. Thanks much.